Hello, this is Eric. Today I'm gonna talk about Wi-Fi connection. When we develop any device, most of the time we need a Wi-Fi connection. In these days, a Wi-Fi connection is essential because Wi-Fi makes sending and receiving data very easy. The way we've been doing so far is hard coding the SSID and password of the wireless router we are connecting to. This can be developed quickly, but it's not possible to dynamically change which Wi-Fi to connect to. To dynamically set Wi-Fi, we need to be able to receive input from the user and we also need a display. This causes a lot of unnecessary work, so we should be able to use a simpler way. Espressif provides several methods to configure Wi-Fi to be connected dynamically. Among them, today I'm gonna look at ESP-Touch protocol and ESP-BluFi protocol. Both of these make devices provisioned through a smartphone. Since all IoT devices are accessed through a smartphone these days, I think it's important to be able to provision using a mobile app. Also, this is particularly important to headless devices and systems due to their lack of the user interface. First, let's take a look at ESP-Touch protocol using SmartConfig technology. ESP-Touch protocol implements the SmartConfig technology to help users connect ESP32 devices to a Wi-Fi network through simple configuration on smartphone. ESP device works in Wi-Fi station mode and starts SmartConfig together. The smartphone is already connected to the AP to which ESP device will connect. Update the credentials of the AP to be connected using the ESP-Touch app on the smartphone and start broadcasting the UDP packet. This packet is sent to the surrounding Wi-Fi device. ESP device checks the UDP packet length, decodes the SSID and password, and then attempts to connect to the access point. When the connection is complete, it informs the user that it has been connected to the smartphone again. Let me show you how it works with a real device. Here's my iPhone and my ESP device. Both iPhone and Android apps are available and I will test it with my iPhone. You can see my iPhone screen here, and on the left, the source code is ready. You can find this demo code from the ESP IDF examples. Find and choose SmartConfig. The SmartConfig part is working on with the Wi-Fi module, so this demo code is not that long. Let me build and flash it to my ESP32. I'm using Roland 32 right. Seems like my device is ready to go. Let me open ESP-Touch app. There are two versions of ESP-Touch. Currently, I'm doing it with ESP-Touch, not ESP-Touch version 2. I'll do the second one soon. The interface is very simple. I can see the SSID of the connected Wi-Fi. You can see the password input field and the number of devices to be updated. It seems that you can update multiple devices at the same time or sequentially. Enter the password and press the confirm button below to start broadcasting the UDP packet. I entered the password, but it doesn't show up on the screen. Apple makes sure that password is not exposed during the screen recording. What a function. Anyway, it's connected. You can check what's going on in the console log. You can see that the SSID and password are decoded normally. Also, it has been assigned the local IP address from the router. Now, this device can transfer data via Wi-Fi. I was able to dynamically establish a Wi-Fi connection very easily. Now, it's time to try the ESP-Touch version 2. Version 2 supports the AES encryption type, so you can enter the pre-shared key. You can also send user data too. To use ESP-Touch version 2, just need to change the type in the SmartConfig. Line number 110 said SSID type ESP-Touch version 2. That's it. Let's rock and roll again. My device is ready. If you look at the console, you can see that it's running as ESP-Touch version 2. Let me update the Wi-Fi credentials. This time, I will include the hello in the custom data. Okay, it's starting for provisioning. Oh, you see on the console log, there are CRC errors. I don't know why, but something went wrong while sending the packets. But it's attempting again automatically. It's really good. Seems like it handles basic communication errors. Let's wait for this. Finally, it's connected normally. SSID and password updated. Also, the custom data I sent arrived well. There is no function to save the current SSID and password to the internal partition in this demo. It seems that it can be used immediately after additional implementation so that it can be reconnected even after rebooting. Let's take a look at ESP-BluFi. ESP-BluFi is based on the BluFi protocol, which connects with IoT devices for BLE data communication, realized device config network, and custom data transfer and reception. Let's see how it works. Set the ESP32 into GATT server mode, and then it will send the broadcast with specific advertising data. The smartphone will connect to ESP32 as the GATT client once the broadcast is confirmed. After the GATT connection is successfully established, the smartphone will send a data frame for key negotiation to ESP32. Through the negotiation process, the phone and ESP32 are ready to communicate using the specific encryption algorithm. The smartphone sends the data frame defined in the section of the frame formats with the Wi-Fi credentials to ESP32, and ESP32 attempts to connect it. After connecting to the Wi-Fi, ESP32 will send the control frame of Wi-Fi connection status report to the smartphone. Let's run BluFi demo with a real device, like ESP-Touch. You can find a demo code from the ESP IDF examples. Basically, ESP32 can use Wi-Fi and Bluetooth at the same time. This is because they are shared the same communication module. However, for simple tasks, it's allowed to be used at the same time. I will deal with this subject on the other project later. My device is ready. Let's see how it works. As soon as the app opened, it detects a device called BluFi device. I'm sure this is my device. It's super fast. Now the device is connected via BLE and the BluFi connection is ready. Oh, what I found on the console log is it's already connected to Wi-Fi. Before making this video, I tested it first. I'm pretty sure this came from that. Anyway, I will ignore this. If we press the scan button, it searches for nearby wireless networks and shows the result. The key negotiation used the default value, so I don't touch it. The current BluFi version of my device is 1.2. Now let's do the provisioning. Here you can select the type of Wi-Fi you want. It can be station mode, access point mode, or both. I will choose the station mode so my ESP32 connects to my wireless network. Enter the password and click the configure button. My ESP32 device gets the old configuration I sent from app and it connects the Wi-Fi network with it. If you look at the console log, you can see that the IP address is assigned from the router. As before, let me send the custom data hello. You can check the byte data has been transferred normally. This also works great. Personally, I find these two very useful. Being able to update Wi-Fi credentials via Bluetooth or UDP is amazing. If you need a Wi-Fi connection on a device without a user interface, it's the best solution for that. I'm not sure which one is better. The way I see it, this may vary from project to project. If we apply it to the real project, we'll be able to know more details. This is all for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.